All right, we're joined by Hannah Clark and Coach Hancock following today's win against Augusta. Coach, just initial reactions after getting that one over with.
Well, I'm glad it's over for sure, but really proud of the effort and the fight and the resiliency that we showed today. It's been a long week for our girls because they've been in exams, you know, a lot of stress, probably staying up late, and we've had maybe 10 days off from a game. I don't know exactly what it is, but it seems like an extended period of time where we haven't played. So for them to get down, kind of get punched in the mouth, they could have easily folded, but I think this group, you know, really has something to prove, and they fought and they came all the way back, and happy that they got a win.
And that kind of leads into my next question, Hannah. A week and a half off for you all. How do you kind of, what did you do in that long layoff? I know you have finals as well, but how does your preparation change a little bit when you have that much more time than usual getting ready for a game?
I think that just as a team, we just got together. We had our shooting groups, and we just stayed focused, stayed in the gym, got our shots up, whether it was by ourselves or with our teammates.
Bree Troutman having foul trouble early on, how did you feel like your team managed that playing without her on the floor, especially the last time you all were on the floor was her career high 30 points?
Two things with that is I thought Bree did a nice job of staying into the game and not getting frustrated and letting that take her completely out of it. But I thought we had other people step up and make really big plays. We had five people in double figures, balanced. I thought that's where Hannah kind of stepped up and got us some baskets. And then, you know, I just can't really go without mentioning Haley Brandon's 20 rebounds. You know, it was the coach was yelling out, like, she's got, like, 20 rebounds. And then when you look on the paper and she actually has 20, that's just pretty amazing to me that, you know, I don't think she's the fastest player, and she certainly doesn't jump the highest out there, but just she's relentless on the boards. Mm-hmm. And I think that played a part in it. She was, she got a big block at the end of the game. And she didn't let, you know, that she wasn't scoring the ball affect her negatively to not go get the rebounds or play defense. So team effort for sure.
I think this can be for both of you kind of from a coaching perspective and a playing perspective. What was the difference in that fourth quarter? What clicked for you all? I guess, Hannah, you can get started.
I think that our energy changed. We knew that we needed to get stops on defense, and it started on defense, and we brought it back on offense, and the energy came from our defense.
Yeah, I would agree, and I'm not sure who said it, but in maybe one of the timeouts, I don't know if it was late in the third quarter or early in the fourth, somebody said, it's our game, this is our game. And everybody sort of nodded their head, and it was like, yeah, this is our game, and sort of everybody bought into that. And I think that's good leadership from our players, because it came from them, not, you know, not from us. So, again, that's a good feeling to see that pay off for them to fight and come out on the winning side of that.
Hannah, my question for you and the teams that you've played on here at Wingate, where does this team rank in terms of chemistry? How much do you all enjoy playing with each other?
Oh, yeah, this team definitely has a lot of chemistry. Just knowing, like, me and Bree, we've been here together for the past 3 years, so we've grown in our chemistry, and then Haley just coming in this last year, we've definitely grown in chemistry, and just everybody together has just grown and worked hard to just learn how each other plays.
All right, Hannah, Coach, thank you both for your time. Congrats on the win.
Thank you.